Have you ever experienced a nightmare that wouldn't end, no matter how hard you tried to wake up? Imagine for a moment an entire town ensnared in just such a torment. Picture a quaint, peaceful place where time stands still, not in a tranquil sense, but in a chilling, petrifying way. As the clock strikes midnight, the townsfolk find themselves stuck in a relentless loop of a tragic event, one that leaves scars on their souls and a haunting echo in their hearts. This is no ordinary nightmare. It's an unending cycle of despair and dread that has seeped into every nook and corner of their lives. Every face in this town carries the same expression, a mix of fear, desperation, and a sense of helplessness that's too profound for words. It's like they're trapped in a macabre painting, forever frozen in a moment of pure terror. Now imagine the emotional toll this takes. The fear of the midnight hour, the anticipation of the impending doom, the frustration of knowing what's coming and being powerless to stop it. It's enough to drive anyone to the brink of insanity. But the human spirit is resilient, isn't it? Even in the face of such horror, they muster the courage to fight back. They've tried everything, from scientific solutions to mystical rituals, from brave sacrifices to desperate pleas. They've reached out to the world. They've reached into their souls. But every effort, every battle against the unseen force has ended in the same cold, harsh reality. The loop remains unbroken. The chilling wind of despair whistles through the silent streets, and the inhabitants brace themselves for the inevitable. They are prisoners of their own existence, victims of an unseen tormentor who toys with time like a cruel puppeteer. The clock strikes midnight yet again, and the town plunges into the same tragic event, like a record stuck on the most terrifying note. The echo of their screams fades into the darkness, swallowed by the relentless cycle of time. And so, the nightmarish cycle continues, the town trapped in a terrifying echo of time. But in every mystery, there lie clues, waiting to be discovered. And so, as our tale unfolds, we see the inhabitants of this ill-fated town, trapped in a relentless cycle of tragedy, begin to perceive the patterns, the anomalies, the inconsistencies in their repeated existence. In the seemingly endless repetition, a handful of observant townsfolk started to notice the peculiarities. The postman's dog, always barking at precisely the same time, the church bell chiming not a second too soon or too late, the same old man, always dropping his hat at the corner of the town square, and the same child, always there to pick it up. The loop was precise, predictable, and yet, utterly incomprehensible. Driven by the instinctive human desire to understand, to make sense of the chaos, these individuals began to question, to theorize. Some speculated that they were trapped in a dream, a collective nightmare from which they couldn't awake. Others proposed a more scientific explanation, a glitch in the matrix of reality, a tear in the fabric of time itself. But amidst these theories and speculations, there was a shared sentiment, a glimmer of hope. If they could understand this phenomenon, could they not also find a way to break free from it? To escape the relentless cycle of tragedy that had befallen them. The townsfolk began to work together, pooling their observations, their theories, their experiences. They scrutinized every detail, every event, every anomaly in the loop. They sought patterns within patterns, clues within the clues. The town's library became a hub of activity, its dusty old books now providing vital insights into the mysteries of time and reality. In the midst of their torment, in the heart of their unending nightmare, a sense of purpose began to take root. Their shared quest for understanding, for escape, drew them closer, gave them something to hold on to amidst the chaos. As the pieces of the puzzle start to fall into place, the hope of breaking free from this tormenting loop flickers in the darkness. Sometimes the truth can be more terrifying than the unknown. Imagine, if you will, a town trapped in a relentless cycle. A time loop of tragedy and despair. The shocking revelation of the cause of this time loop is nothing less than a chilling nightmare, a horror story unfolding in the harsh light of day. A bitter truth emerged from the shadows of uncertainty, a truth that sent shivers down the spines of the town's inhabitants. The time loop, the eternal recurrence of their sorrow. It wasn't some capricious turn of fate or cruel twist of nature, no. It was the result of a sinister experiment gone horribly wrong, conducted by one of their own, a respected member of the community. The revelation hit the townsfolk like a wave of icy dread, a dreadful realization that the chains that bound them, the cycle of anguish they were trapped in, was a creation of human hands. The horror they felt was palpable, a tangible cloud of fear and revulsion that hung over the town like a shroud. The implications of this newfound knowledge were staggering. If one of their own was capable of such a monstrous act, what did that say about them as a community, as a society? How could they trust each other, live with each other, knowing that one among them was capable of such an atrocity? The town was gripped by a fear more profound, more chilling than the fear of the unknown. It was the fear of the known, the fear of the terrible truth they had uncovered, the fear of the monster in their midst. It was the fear of themselves, the fear of what they were capable of. With every tick of the clock, with every turn of the time loop, this fear grew, it festered, it gnawed at their sanity. It was a fear that threatened to tear them apart, to reduce them to nothing more than terrified, paranoid shadows of their former selves. With the terrible truth revealed, the town's residents are now faced with an unthinkable choice. Imagine being faced with a decision that could either save you or doom you forever. In the heart of this quaint, time-lost town, the inhabitants found themselves grappling with a choice as dark as the endless nights they were trapped in. The decision was like a ghost, haunting every conversation, lurking in every shadowy corner of their minds, as relentless as the ticking clock that seemed to be stuck in a never-ending loop. The town square became a stage set for heated debates and desperate pleas. Once amicable neighbors turned into adversaries, torn apart by the torment of their predicament. The echo of their arguments filled the chilling air, their voices carrying the weight of their fear, their frustration. The decision, it seemed, was more than just a choice. It was a battle, a struggle against the very fabric of their reality. And then there was silence. The quiet was not a respite, but a reflection of the fear that held them captive. The fear of making the wrong decision. The fear of the unknown that lay beyond their choice. The fear of being trapped in their tragic loop forever. It was in the silence that the emotional turmoil truly set in. The town was gripped by an invisible force, a force that was not a ghost or a monster, but the raw, unfiltered dread that comes from the uncertainty of the future. Mothers clutched their children a little tighter, old friends shared knowing glances, and the town's elders looked on with a heavy sadness in their eyes. Yet within this tumult, there was courage. Courage in the face of the daunting decision that lay before them. Courage in the resolve to break free from the chains of their endless nightmare. Courage in the shared determination to reclaim their lives, their town, from the clutches of this haunting decision. In the face of fear and uncertainty, the town's residents must make a choice, their fate hanging in the balance. In the darkest of times, even the faintest glimmer of hope can illuminate the path forward. And so, we find ourselves at the precipice of an unusual twist in the tale. A tale that has been painted with hues of dread and despair so far, now sees a streak of light piercing through the somber canvas, a potential escape from the seemingly unending nightmare. As the story unfolded, the once tranquil town, now ensnared in a chilling time loop, stumbled upon a possible solution to their predicament. This unexpected turn of events was not without its share of skepticism, as the townsfolk have already endured countless false dawns. Yet, the mere possibility of an end to their suffering was enough to ignite a spark of hope amidst the sea of despair. This newfound hope, as faint as it may be, was like a soothing balm on the fresh wounds of the town's collective psyche. It stirred a sense of anticipation, a longing for liberation from the relentless cycle of dread. The town, which had been shrouded in a cloak of desolation, was now buzzing with a mix of hopeful whispers and cautious conversations. But with hope came apprehension. The townsfolk, although desperate for an escape, were equally wary of the potential consequences. The fear of the unknown, of what lies beyond the loop, was palpable. The thought of their world collapsing once more was a specter that loomed large in their minds, yet the glimmer of hope persisted. It was a beacon in the storm, a lighthouse guiding their way through the tempestuous sea of uncertainty. It was the promise of a new dawn, of a day when the sun would rise, not to herald the repetition of a tragic event, but to embrace a day of liberation. As we leave the town at the brink of a possible escape, one can't help but wonder, will they finally break free, or will the nightmare continue? Stay tuned for part 3.